Hello friends, welcome to B.Sc. Agriculture. If you are coming to my channel for the first time, then don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Your subscription and likes are always motivating us. If you have any doubt in this video, please comment in the sections, or else you can be able to join us in the Instagram page and you can be able to ask your doubt, which is in the description link. So let's move to the video. In this video, we are going to see about fundamentals of entomology. I am going to cover the tropism as well as the biocommunication in insects. And I am also used to cover the sound as well as the light production, which is performed by the different insects. So while seeing about the tropism in insects, it is nothing but the orientation of an animal with respect to the stimuli which is made by the environment. So there are two tropisms, which is the positive one as well as the negative one. So the positive one turns towards the stimuli, as well as the negative one which turns away the stimuli. So which act as a defensive mechanism in some of the insects. So this mechanism of orientation is said to be known as the kinesis as well as the taxis. So the kinesis, which is said to be an undirected locomotor reaction made by the stimuli of the insect, as well as there is no particular orientation of long axis of the body relative to the stimuli sources, is said to be made in the insect body, as well as the taxis, which are said to be directed response of the insect, which involves in the movement of relative to the stimuli sources, which towards are used to away from the stimuli of the particular insect. So after that, we are going to see about the kinesis as well as the taxis, which can be defined based on the stimuli. So animokinesis as well as animotaxis, which is said to be made from the direct air current, as well as the astrokinesis, which is for the solar as well as lunar, chemo, where taste and odor, and phono, which is used for known as sound, as well as the photo, which is a light, and a reho, which is water current messages, as well as the thermo from temperature, as well as thigmo, which is used to be done by the contact touch of the insect. So this orientation of movement, and the movement may be positive or negative with respect to the stimuli sources of the particular insects. For example, resistant to gravity is said to be termed as negative geotaxis, as well as the attraction to light is said to be known as positive phototaxis, and the repulsion from moisture is said to be known as the negative hygrotaxis or rheotaxis. So these are the different names of different stimuli. So while seeing an insect, so they use it to communicate in different ways. So they are said to be the communication, which is said to be as like as in humans, where they use to exchange different information from one individual insect to another one. So the insect communication is said to be made by the sensory signal that affect a behavior change in an animal is a communication. So the communication is an influence of signal from one organism on the behavior, as well as the psychology of another organism, with the outcome being beneficial to the sender as well as receiver, or it can be communicated for both of the individual insects. So the insect communication is said to be mainly for the location of food sources as well as the mating process. So the communication is said to be known as semiochemicals, light production, sound production, as well as the body language of different insects. So first of all, we must need to know why the insects are said to be communicate. So they are said to be communicate for the recognition of the nest mates, as well as the kin, as well as the locating or identifying a member of the opposite sex, and facilitation of courtship and mating, giving direction for location of food, as well as the regulating spatial distribution of individual aggregation, as well as dispersion, and establishing and maintaining a different territory of insects, and warning of danger and setting off an alarm when there is a danger in for the colony, and expression threat or submission, and a mimicry of some other insects. So it's why the insect are used to communicate. So I am going to tell you the first one, which is about the chemical communication. It is said to be the most common form of communication among insects. Until now, it is said to be the most common in most of the insects in the environment. So they are said to be intra or interspecific communication, and the chemical functions as the interspecially active one, which is said to be known as the pheromones, which is the chemical compound responsible for the communication between different insects, and the chemical involved in specific communication are grouped as allomores as well as the chiromores. So these are the chemicals which is made by the insects for the communication. And while seeing the types of insect pheromones, the first one in pheromones, the first trial mark pheromones, so which is secreted by the gut or epidermal glands, which is mainly in termites as well as ant, and the mandibular glands, which is the workers of myriopine as well as the male bombus species from the stationary mark on flight paths in the air, and the sex attractants, which is said to be known as the sex pheromones. So that they are said to be secreted from the abdominal glands of female moth, example bombicol, so from which the bombax mori, gossypure, malcure from mucus, musca are said to be different chemicals which are secreted by these different insects. So the male of Danis clippus, which used to produce courtship of Danidone for the sex attracted, and I have given the pictures of bombicol, bombyx mori. So and the assembly or aggregation pheromones, so they are secreted from sex glands, which is a mandibular gland of Q and B, to induce the formation of lores temporary as well as the periston aggregation of the species, as well as the spacing pheromone, which is said to be made by terrific fly, which is said to be a fruit fly which lay eggs singly in a fruit where a single maggot is said to be developed in that particular fruit. And when the female deposits an ovipositon determinant pheromone on the fruit to avoid subsequent ovipositon, so this is used to provide appropriate spacing on fruit resources for the pupa as well as the larva of that particular fruit. And alarm pheromone, so there are secretion of mandibular and abdominal glands to cause the insect receiving them to run or fly or more activity and to show aggressive behavior. So we can able to see the alarm pheromone in ant as well as honeybee and some termite colonies. After that we are going to see about allomones as well as chiromones. So while seeing the allomones, they are said to be chemically released by member of one of the species in that particular colony, which induces a response that adaptively favorable to the emitter of the colony. For example, the repugnatorial substance which is released by a bug in response to a predator would be acting as an allomone to the bug in that particular environment. After that, the chiromones, which are said to be a chemical released by one organism and induce a response that is adaptively favorable to the receiver. For example, the lactic acid in human precipitation acts as a chiromone which used to attract mosquito in our environment. So after that, we are going to see about visual communication. So it is said to be the second form of communication in different insects, where you use it to require a direct line of sight between two different insects. So the vision is said to be important for the courtship signaling as well as defensive of their colony, as well as the prey finding in per some of the insects. Some insects are bioluminescent, as well as use light production and reception is the mode of communication, which is said to be known as the bioluminescence. You must need to remember it. For example, the fireflies used to have light production organs, and the larva as well as the female have a single pair, where the male used to have a two pairs of light production unit in them. I have given the picture of firefly lamprey. So after that, we are going to see about the audio communication. So it is nothing but a sound communication, which is also one of the effective mode of communication in wide range of insects. They are said to be preceptive for the specialized mechanoreceptors are made in the insect, where they are mainly useful for the location of mate. Example, wing beating in male Aedes mosquito, which is used to attract female flight tone, as well as the striking the substrate body. Grasshopper used to strike the ground with their hind tibia to bring the individuals together, as well as the termite tap against the floor with the mandible to warm the other members on disturbance about the prey as well as the predator in that environment. And stridation, which is the production of sound by rubbing together of two body surfaces, which is said to be mainly in grasshoppers, where the hind pheromone and fore pheromone, and in cat and cricket, the cubital vein of each forewing is said to be toothed, and the vibrating membrane or thimble produces sound in moth as well as the homoptins and cicadas, where the first abdominal segment is said to be highly modified and has a pair of dorsal structure resembling drum heads in the insect colony. After that, the fourth one, which is a body communication. So they are said to be a dancing language, where you can able to see an example of bee dances. So the first one I am going to tell you is the round dance, where they use it to tell about the availability of food is near, produced nearby area is communicated to rescue scouts in a colony by a simple round dance which is made by a bee, and the quality of nectar or pollen which is helped to be communicated by the vigor of the dance in that for that colony. So running in a circle which is performed by a closed chute, so they can able to deliver the message to each and every colony. And the waggle dance, so it is a source of nectar which is far away from the colony, about 100 meters or more, the dance is performed. So in this, the bee runs straight ahead from the short distance and moves in a semicircle and to the starting point and runs through the axis and describes the semicircle in opposite direction. It's how the waggle dance is said to be done by the honeybees. And the bee dance you can able to see. And after that, the final one, which is a sickle dance, it is a halfway dance between round and wagging type, which used to indicate the nectar is said to be an intermediate distance. So I have given the lecture notes in description. If you have any doubt, please comment in the section or else join in the Instagram and ask your doubts. If you like the video, like it and share it with your friends and subscribe to B.Sc. Agriculture and hit the bell icon to get regular updates. So thanks for watching the video. I'll catch you up in next videos.